In this video, I'm going to break down why setting column widths with fraction units in CSS Grid doesn't always result in columns being the same size, and I'll show you how to fix it. All right, so this is a very common pattern that I keep seeing in code reviews sometimes in other projects, and I think it's best if I walk you through it with a demo. So imagine you're building a website for a donut shop where your task is to build a grid showcasing cards for each donut flavor available for purchase. So we have glazed, we have chocolate, we have pickle delight. I know that's a very questionable flavor, but remember, our job is to build the best interface, not judge the flavor of donuts. So if you're diving into CSS and just heard about concept of grids, you'll probably end up on MDN and learn that it's pretty straightforward to build a simple grid with three columns, right? You set display grid and set grid template columns to three fraction units, one FR, one FR, one FR. Or if you want to be concise, you can use a repeat function to say repeat three, one FR. Now you add that to your styles and you have nice grid with three columns. Now the plot thickens when you get an email from a client saying something like, hey, so we need to swap Pickle Delight. It's not doing very well on sales. Shocking twist, I know. Here's an info for a new donut. So you get an info, you see that it's a strawberry donut, which is an improvement, with the funky name Strawberry-liciousness. Well, that's a little, but again, we're not judging, like, okay, clients. So you take the info, update the website, and something looks off. The columns are not the same size now. Why is that? It looks like a bug. Turns out it's not actually a bug, but a feature. So when we set our grid columns to one fraction, we're basically saying, hey, divide this space evenly into three parts. But what often gets overlooked in the docs and tutorials and manuals is that fraction units are sort of like polite units. They would make room for any content that needs more space before they distribute the rest. So when Strawberry-liciousness donut rolls in, it demands more space because the word doesn't break or hyphenate by default. In other words, or in CSS terms, one fraction minimum value is auto. So this means that not only long words can break the grid, if there is a large image that doesn't have display block and max width set to 100 by default, it would also break the grid. And there could be other scenarios. So how do we fix it? There are two things we could do. First, we could use min-max function in CSS and explicitly set the min value to 0, so it's no longer dependent on the content that's inside. In our case, it's Strawberry-liciousness long word. And second, we can also set the min width of columns to 0. I lean towards the first approach because it keeps the styles related to the grid neatly in one spot. So this fixes the grid, but now we have this issue with the title. We can fix that by adding these two declarations globally. First, we add overflow rep to make sure that the long words are breaking to the next line, and we can set hyphens to auto. One thing to note about hyphens is that they don't always work the way we want them to. Browsers make the best attempt to put them in correct spots, but like in our case, it doesn't always work. So for strange words like ours, we can insert a soft hyphen character in the spot where we want the hyphen to appear, and that will signal the browser to hyphenate that at that exact spot. And that hyphen character will not appear visually if the hyphen is not needed. So there you have it. Now you know how to make sure that the columns are the same size in CSS Grid. And by the way, I don't like how the buttons are not on the same line inside the cards, but I'll cover that in another video. So if you don't want to miss out, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one. I'm gonna go get myself some donuts.